Hello from Wilcott Mill, and let's take a look around here, and I'm going to try something a little different. Maybe we'll have some conversation as we go around. First, let's look at the map and see what they have here. Some really nice hiking trails, plus there's a old mill. So I'm going to walk over to the mill, and we'll see what's there at the mill. And I think it's closed today, but we can at least go around the outside of the buildings. Okay. Now, Wilcott Mill is divided up into three areas. This is the mill itself. They also have a farm, which is an operating farm that you can go to. And then the last part is their north trails, which are a paved trail. If I get a chance, we'll go over there today and take a look at that. But the paved trail is nice because if you're maybe handicapped or a little older or something like that and you're not able to do as much walking, you can get out there and enjoy the trails. So, and now we're coming up on what is the farm stand itself, or the farm mill itself. So let's take a look around here and see what we see. So over on this side, you've got some outbuildings and the rest area, or the restrooms, and a little garage. And then back over on this side is the mill itself. So, and then we have some mill buildings here. Okay, let's drive over to the North Trails. We just looked at the mill. The North Trails are the paved trails, so hopefully those will be nice and clear and we can do some walking over there and we can see what those are like. Okay, this is the North Branch Trails at Wolcott Mill. These are the paved trails that you can go all around on. So like if you're maybe in a wheelchair or something like that, you mobility problems, they're paved so you can get around on them. I'm going to show you the map and then we'll take a quick look at these and see what's here. As you can see, there's about 4.5 miles of total trails, but the trails are much shorter, so if you only want to go a mile or two, they have that. You don't have to do all 4.5. That would be doing everything on the trails. So I think I'm going to stop here and turn back because the trail is a little flooded. But this kind of gives you an idea of what the trails are like in the summer. It's much nicer out here, but just wanted to give you a feel for the winter time here. And I know the trails on the other side are higher up on the ground,
as opposed to these, which are down here by the water. So perhaps those aren't as flooded out. But this will give you just a feel for what it's like out here. Nice and flat, easygoing. So one thing to note here in the parking lot is they do have some portable bathrooms if you need to use them. And I'm sure it's not the best experience in the world, but if you have to use it, they're there for you. So that's the North Branch Trails. And now...
So now let's go and see about seeing about the farm center. That's the last part of the three parts of Wolcott Mill. Okay, this is the Wolcott Mill Farm Center, and they have a pond you can see behind me. And then if I come around like this, you can see the farm center back there And I'll put some pictures of the cows in, some video of the cows in back there. The farm center itself was closed up today. Okay, so that's Wolcott Mill Park. It's located in Ray, Michigan. The park costs $10 a day to get into, or you can buy an annual pass to get into all the metro parks around the Detroit area, and that's $40. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I look forward to seeing you in future videos. Also, check out some of the other videos in my playlist. Thanks.